Lucky here. It's the Pat and JT Podcast.
Pat and JT Podcast.
PatandJT.com. Go to the website. Links to everything. It's Pat and JT on all social media. Or 402-403-9478 for texting or voicemail. Give us a call.
Thank you very much. Absolutely. Saw a funny story about Kelly Ripa. There's a picture of her standing in a full-length mirror in her house.
Yeah.
And she says, not real big on the fashion photographs here, fashion selfies. It's just that I've lived in this house for 11 years and I just discovered this full-length mirror on the backside of my bedroom door. And I'm
like... Like your door's never been closed ever?
Right.
Must not have been.
She just discovered this huge, I mean, it is. It's a full-length mirror, covers the entire back of the door.
That's crazy.
I'm like thinking, has that ever happened in my house? Is there anything that I've recently discovered I didn't know I had? Or you realize.
Maybe realize what something's for. Like, that's for blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, because there's something in your house that the previous owners had done and you're like, why? That's what that's for. And all of a sudden it dawns on you. Same way like when you're driving down the street and all of a sudden you look around instead of just looking straight ahead and you're like, I didn't know that was there.
Right.
I didn't know. When did they build that?
Yeah.
Same kind of.
Yeah. Because you're usually, especially if it's your path, your track, your game trail, and you never look up and you just get in the zone. You forget how you even got there.
It's but
true. Then you're driving all of a sudden like, that was a water tower? The water tower there? Since when?
Or there are train tracks there because there's a train crossing.
Yeah.
I've noticed that recently because we're kind of off of, we're close to 156th and Center, which those train tracks go right across Center.
Mm-hmm.
And until we started working in this area, I'd been through that intersection 1,000 times, never seen a train there. But now that we're every day, and the first time I saw a train, it was just like, huh.
Is that supposed to be there?
I didn't know that. And there's some train tracks just north of our office that I thought were dead.
Yeah, they're not. They're alive.
They are not.
They're alive.
There was a train sitting on them, and it crosses 144th Street just south of Center. And does that mess up the flow?
That intersection is a mess anyway, just in general.
It is.
Yeah.
It's 144th and Center is awful. And there are probably other ones that are out there as well that are just as bad. And by the way, I'm just going to tell you, Jack is in the studio. And I had his toy up on the table away from him. And he just climbed up on the chair and he got it off the table.
Yep. Very gently.
Very
so now,
gently.
Yes, so now we can go kill it. There you
Squeaking
go.
Commence.
Oh, just, please take it in the conference room.
Awesome. He just left.
He'll be back in 14 seconds. What are you talking about?
But there are several intersections in town that are just terrible, but that's got to be one of the worst ones.
That's
as far
bad.
As the angles.
It's just, it's just weird.
Yeah. Just like, overall.
Yeah. 104, it used to be for me like the Boys Town 144th onto Dodge Street, that whole situation, but now they've widened 144th, so that helps a lot.
That's huge. But they did that, about 10 years ago is when they widened it, if you can believe it's been that long,
because
it was right after I moved into that house, and I'm right off 144th in Dodge area, the Boys Town area, and that's when they started working on 144th. And I just moved in. It was a mess for a long time.
when they start projects and they say projected to be done in 8 years, like, oh my God. And then you look back, it goes super fast. But like Harrison expansion from 144th out, it seems like it's been 10 years for them to expand from. No, they just opened 100 and Sophia was not a boyfriend, but Sophia was talking to a gentleman, a boy, that lived just west of the barricades just on Harrison, and they broke up a week before it opened. I'm like, you've got to be kidding me. We have to go up to Chandler and around to Q and around.
Time.
I'm like, dude, you just get back together with him for a week
just to enjoy this little jaunt.
It cut like 20 minutes off of the just getting around.
They just finished on Blondo too. They're almost ready to open up 156th as two lanes in each direction, which is, I can't wait.
And
I haven't been down there for a couple, 3 days. So who knows? Maybe it's open already, but I know it's really close and I can get through on Blondo again too. And they're still working on that section, but it is, it's just like one of those things when they first did the Dodge Expressway,
right?
That opened not long after we started.
Yeah, it was right.
Our radio show.
And now it seems like it's been there forever.
I know. And I think about all those businesses that are under the expressway right there. Cause at first that was hard on them. They had a terrible, because everything was just closed down while they were constructing everything.
Yeah.
And I thought, man, there's no way they're going to be able to make it down there. And, you know, because people would drive right over them. But no, everything's
fine.
It all falls back together again. Yeah. And everybody
freaks out, but we're okay.
I can't imagine not having it, though. You're right.
All right, 402-403-9478. Texties. Says, hey guys, this is from Jessica. Hey guys, love the show. Just wanted you to know my friend and his mom ran Siam Cuisine in Bellevue for years. Unfortunately, she retired 2 years ago and it's now closed randomly. Heard it recommended in connection with Dan Hoppin's.
Oh.
Restaurant Hoppin.
Yeah.
Podcast that we produce for Parkville Media. Just wanted to share. Yeah. And it's from Kyle Thomas, husband of one of the biggest fans, Shannon Thomas. What is that? Thanks, Kyle.
I've corresponded with Shannon before.
Yeah.
We've posted back and forth. We'll say.
And yeah. Biggest fans is in all caps. So thank you, Kyle. So, okay, Jessica sent in to 402.
Speak up a little bit or turn my mic down.
Sorry, here, I'll mute you. There you go. There you go. 402, 403. Now he's not even chewing on the thing.
I know.
402. There you go. That's. Oh, my God. 402-403-9478 from Jessica. She goes, okay, there are so many other... A while ago, we did a podcast, an episode of words you just hate or words you love. Right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Jessica sent these in. Conundrum, discombobulated, and exacerbate.
Exacerbate. Yeah. That one always catches me off guard when I see it written down. I can say it, but then when I see it, it's like I have to think a minute how to say it.
Exacerbate, yeah. And those are the ones she wanted me to produce. And you know what?
You
did a great job, Jessica.
You did better saying pronounced than produced.
I did, right? I pronounced it right.
You produced it right. that was when they had that kind of like the, what do I want to say, brackets for the best word.
Yes, for the best word.
The best word.
And I don't remember if conundrum or discombobulated or exacerbate were on there.
I don't believe, I think conundrum was. I'm not sure. Really? I'm not sure.
And you know what, Jessica, you're... Was that his head?
No. He's just flailing his toy around.
Jessica said, don't block her. So we're not going to block you.
Never.
No, we're not going to block you. You're rude, but we're not going to block you. We would like to thank Kugler Vision for their support of our podcast.
Super excited about this, too, because you know what's coming up. It's the year of Kugler Vision.
It's the year they've been waiting for since Dr. Kugler was a baby Kugler. I can't wait for 2020, Mom. He's looking up at her.
I'm going to be an eye doctor.
Yes.
2020 is going to be my year.
It's perfect.
This is going to be the best one. And it could be your year, too. Now, Pat and I have both had the procedure done on our eyes and had our vision corrected. My goodness. The one thing I always say, the only regret I had is I didn't do it sooner. And if you have any trepidation, if you're fearful, trust me, a lot of people have already told us about this, that they were fearful. They trusted us to go ahead and make that consultation appointment so you can go in and meet the whole gang. And then you all of a sudden feel that security and you realize that this is a win-win situation. They want you to be comfortable in. And once you understand what's going on and what you can achieve, it just all of a sudden takes the fear away.
That's right. And also, you don't have to just trust us. I mean, 3 years in a row, they've been voted best of Omaha. So a lot of people in the Omaha area and the region trust Kugler Vision.
Not just a lot. We can actually put a number to it to a degree. They have over 600 happy patient reviews. Over 600 of them. And so, yeah, the 3 years in a row, and I think they're doing pretty well. So this could be the year. 2020 is just around the corner, and you want to see it coming.
That's right.
See what I did there? Okay.
When you make your consultation, you need to let them know that the Pat and JT podcast is where you heard about Kugler Vision, and that's who sent you to go see them.
That's really important. I mean, we want them to know that our supporters are supporting them.
Go to their website. It's kuglervision.com. This was from No Name. It just says, you guys were talking about Yoni, Y-O-N-I.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just wanted to say there is a brewery in Poland called The Order of Yoni, and they brew a couple of beers using vaginal bacteria.
Oh, my God.
I've not tried them. I have no desire to try them.
Oh, my God.
Says No Name.
Oh, I have not. That's when we were talking about sunning things that shouldn't have sun on them.
Yes.
Perineum? Yes. Is that a flat perineum? That's not a flower, is
your
it?
Your hoop.
Oh, my God.
Tanning your hoop. Yeah, we don't want to do that. And why? And there are a million, billion types of bacteria, and you have to go there
really
to get the bacteria? Hi, Pat and JT. This is Danae. I just want to let you guys know how much I love the show. Thanks, Danae. I'm getting pretty nervous because we're getting close to episode 365.
Yes.
It'll be a full year. Please promise you I'll continue to do the podcast after that. I mean, if you want to drop the weekends, I suppose that'd be okay, but I need my weekday fix. Also, just listen to today's episode about the Keurig, which was a couple of days ago.
Yeah.
You guys should really get reusable pods. You just put together. And I've used reusable pods in the past.
Yes. They're hard to clean.
Yes. And they're just not as convenient.
Well, Danae. That's because that's where the lazy part comes in. No, you're absolutely right. We should. We should look into that because that would be much more economical and make our footprint smaller, right? He doesn't care.
I mean, I love animals. I love all the earth. I love the earth. You know what? In 100 years, daddy's going to be out. So, you know, I mean, I don't want to sound insensitive, but.
But there it is.
I'm being sensitive.
No, we should look into that. You usually bring coffee with you.
I usually do. And I like maybe once a week I'll throw in a donut shop in the Keurig.
It's been awesome having it though. I'd forgotten because I had it put it away for years.
Yeah. I have one at the house that I use and I just love it. Awesome. I mean, obviously Keurigs are great. And now that they have the one that you make cocktails in them.
Yes. I like making iced tea in them.
Yeah.
Well, you can brew the tea in over ice.
It's brilliant.
Delicious.
It really is brilliant.
Oh my God.
Speaking of,
he's just in my lap, just chewing on that thing. Give it to me.
In the studio, by the way.
Ouch!
If you didn't know,
I wish you could see this. That was my own fault.
He didn't care.
You don't try and take a toy away out of a German Shepherd's mouth.
No, no, you don't.
I'll just stay right here.
That's why. Yeah, just see how long he sits. She's holding it up in the air. I'm just actually gonna take a picture of this so we can put it up on Facebook. And then, okay, here we go. And then. There. All right, we'll see how long he's going to stay like that. So go to our Facebook page and you'll see a picture of Jack. I even said his name. He didn't even flinch.
He didn't even flinch.
He's not breathing. No, he'll all of a sudden gasp.
This is crazy.
He literally hasn't been breathing. That is awesome.
Now he's mouth breathing. Anyway, I'm sure it's fun for everybody at home. Sorry about that.
On Facebook too, facebook.com/PatAndJT. It's Pat and JT. Instagram, yeah. It's Pat and JT, and also on Twitter, it's Pat and JT.
And by the way, if you know John Carroll, mm-hmm. shoot him a note and tell him to get back to us.
Is he not returning?
He's been traveling a lot. I know that too. Chad's been putting videos up, and you know John Carroll. He's been a friend of the show. Has been on the show. He's an attorney locally, and then he has his goats. And he and his partner Chad have the goat farm, and they have the famous San Clemente goats, the largest herd in the world. And you probably remember talking about them when they were going through the flooding and trying to find a place for them that would be safe, higher ground. So Chad has been posting Willow Valley Farms. As what they go by, but you can find him on Facebook and he posts videos of him and his goats.
It's pretty awesome.
He's like the goat whisperer and it's pretty awesome.
So go to Willow Valley Farms, go to John, whatever, post on his Facebook page and just say, or tweet to him, go to Instagram and say he needs to get back in here.
We want to have him on the podcast.
We haven't had him on a full episode since episode like 7 and 8, 8 or 9. It was single digits
that we
had John on. Yeah.
Wow.
So it's been a minute. So we need to get him back in.
I want him back up, but I know he's been traveling a lot because Chad showed a huge puzzle he's been working on while John was gone. But he had a really cool picture that they posted. They have a really large aquarium. It's got to be 100 gallons.
It's huge, yeah.
I'm thinking that because I had a 50-gallon one once or 55, and this is like twice the length.
So that'd be about 100 then.
Right about... smart ass. Anyway, right about that... And but it's in a wall, and so you can see it from both sides. So it's in one of their guest bedrooms, and then in the living room, and it's lit. It's really cool.
It's pretty cool.
Really cool. Yeah, that old farmhouse is cool. So we'll have to get him in here.
Post it on his Facebook page.
Yeah.
Do it. text us 402-403-9478. We're rolling closer to 365, but we're not going to stop doing our podcast.
No.
Thank you guys for listening, downloading, subscribing, rating, reviewing, telling mom, wake her up, let her know we're doing our podcast. Thank you.
Pat and JT Podcast, a Parkville Media Production.